Hey guys, MomoGuru here again to give you a little demo of some of the latest features I've implemented in my new project. So we got our carrier here. I'm going to go ahead and start building. I need a research lab, and I'm going to start with two workers, and I want to get that carrier over next to them rocks. Because, actually, is there any rocks that way? No, there's not. Yeah, just simply because it's going to, I need to get my carrier close to my workers for that first attack wave. And bam, there's my research lab. So I can start researching. All right, open my lab. I'm going to go for frigate drive first, simply because I'm going to get that ore processor out. And there's a worker and another worker. Select them both. And I'm going to hotkey my workers into group 5 and send them on their way. Actually, I'm going to send them over here. That's a good spot. So you can Z bandbox and you can Z click. So they're basically the same thing. All right, and I'm going to get my research lab guarding my carrier so that as I move my carrier around, I'm not leaving my research ship out to get crushed. The game is playable, and what I mean by playable is that it's challenging. I've got attack waves set up every 2 minutes or so. It sends an attack wave, and the attack waves get progressively difficult, and you eventually get crushed. I'm trying to tweak some things and make it so that the progression to difficulty scales a little bit, maybe, based on how you play, but I'm not sure if I'm going to implement that or not. All right, so now that I got a couple workers going, I need to get that ore processor out, and I'm going to move my carrier a little bit closer since they're going to have to travel that way. How to move vertical, you just hold your shift key while you're in the move command, and you'll see my carrier will start to drop down. Capital ships and frigates and things like that, they will have to turn a little bit before they can start moving, where strike craft kind of turn on a dime. All right, so I'm out of money, and I'm waiting for those workers to come and drop me off stuff, and there's the first attack wave. A couple recons, nothing major. So I'm going to open up my guns from my carrier and get those guys shooting. Strike craft is pretty weak, and I can fight off the first few waves just with my carrier, but eventually I want to get some support frigates out and start building up my frigate fleet, because they will start sending frigates at you and eventually destroyers and stuff. Alright, so let's see where I'm at here. I still haven't got that ore processor out yet. It's close. What am I researching? Anything? Good. No. Okay, so I need to get a support frigate research going, but until I do that, I just need to wait for these workers to fill up some more. So I'm going to scoot just a little bit closer if I can. Let's go right about there. And as I progress, I don't want to get too close. I'm going to hit the stop key. And let's see. All right. Workers are coming back. I got about a minute before the next attack wave. And you can see the way that workers drop off the RU. Rather than making them actually do like a dock with the ship, I decided that causes a lot of problematic stuff with the physics, and rather than worrying about some of the issues that Homeworld Remaster is having with the collectors and practically every ship with some of the collision stuff that's going on, I decided to try to circumvent that completely by not making the workers dock. I mean, the workers don't have to dock with the asteroid, so I don't think they have to dock with the carrier. And what I'm going to do is have a special effect where you can see the ore dust being transferred to the carrier and being sucked up. So it all makes sense, you know, visually and logically. It just won't look exactly the same as it does in our current game. All right, so we're going there. I got a little bit of money. I suspect I should build something, and I'm going to go for an assault frigate. And I also need to start researching. My carrier's close enough to fire. Yeah, I'm in range. Let's pick those guys off. They will do some damage. You can see, like, it's not too much, but They will start to do some damage, even the smaller recons in larger numbers and interceptors. And like I said, I'm still balancing these things out, so it's going to take a little time before I get it exactly, you know, hit those sweet spots. But luckily, it's not something where you have to stop and do it every time. You can literally find the sweet spot by using the ship editor. And the way the ship editor works is it's got all the ships that are in the game, and then you can create a ship or a new ship out of any ship. I can click bomber and change the name and change the class and type and add different descriptions and stuff. But what's important is you check out the stats. You can see our bomber has these stats that, you know, everything from ship size and hits points, you know, and then it's got some Boolean variables, you know, can you drop off RU at this ship? Is it a build capable ship? Is it a research capable ship? And then it's got some other things like what technologies are required to be able to have that ship available and stuff like that. Then you can jump into the weapons, and then you can see that there are 6 weapon slots per ship. So not all, you know, like the bomber is only using 2 of those weapon slots. It's got 2 plasma bombs. The recon's using 1 rail gun. I think an interceptor uses 2. So it's pretty simple. And there is our frigate. I'm going to go ahead and control hotkey that into group number 2. And we got a little bit of money, so I'm going to use that on research because I want to get a support frigate out. Because if you plan on surviving any waves here, then you're going to have to start supporting your ships almost right from the get-go because you'll start losing workers. And once you start, your money starts dropping. That's pretty much game over. All right, so we got a support frigate cooking. I'm going to get one more worker going before I get that support frigate out. And there's worker, ore processor, my frigate. All right, so I'm doing pretty good. I'm going to close that, get it out of the way. I got about 11 seconds before the next wave comes. And I'm not doing too bad. I got a little bit of defense. Now I need to start pumping out some workers, get going. I haven't really figured out how I want to do this. I want to make it so that build-capable ships will show what is being built, but I'm not sure if that's just overkill since you can just click the build menu right there. And these menus are all draggable. You can move them around wherever you want. I just leave them right here because it's easy. All right. Let's see where we at. So you can see the ships that have research capability or build capability are listed a lot bigger. And just by clicking it, it selects that ship. So when you have multiple ships, then like 3 workers, if I click that, it's only going to select those 3 workers. I'm going to hit the H key and get that 3rd one going. Get these guys. There we go. And let's see. Let's support. Okay, we got some attacking. All right, so the mess with that, I think I can build a support frigate now. Yes. And let's pump out 2 more workers. And hopefully I can get that support frigate out pretty quick. All righty. Looking pretty good so far. Everything seems to be running really smooth. There's no lag, or the FPS in test mode seem to be running between 68 and 58, and I'm sure when you get 100 or so more ships on the screen, you're going to drop down to, you know, the 40s or 30s, depending on what kind of stuff. I mean, if you got a really good graphics card and you got lots of memory and a good processor, I don't suspect you're going to have much issue. All right, finish that guy off there. All right, so now where is my support frigate? Okay, there's a worker. Let's get him going. Worker out. Support frigate is slowly coming. Come on. Let's go ahead and cancel that worker. Let's get the support frigate finished real quick. And then I'm going to pump out another worker. Alright, so now I got a support frigate. I need to start healing some stuff, so I'm just going to bandbox my research lab and get that guy going. Alright, so a bunch of fighters just left this planet, and the fighters spawn from different areas. You'll notice that it's completely random, and they have, you know, got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 planets on the screen. Each planet has asteroids around it. It's in your best interest to try to set up shop next to a planet that's not next to every other one. So if you can find one planet kind of by itself, that way it's going to increase your chances of survival, especially just in the little demo mode that I got going here. All right, so we're getting cooked up there. Everybody's shooting good. Wiping out that. Let's jump into the lab and move up to. Let's get our fighter drive going. We got a little bit of money, and we're going to the build menu and build. See, we got some interceptors. I'm gonna pump up 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. Let's just go 10, and I'll build 2 more workers. And let's see if we get those out. All right, got another lazy worker over here. I should put an icon on lazy worker so that even in sensors mode, when you zoom out, you can actually see. Now in sensors mode, you can zoom in all the way. It basically, what it's doing is it's colorizing all your ships. You see they're all green, and it just kind of makes it a little bit easier to view. So depending on if that's what you're going for, that's what. And sensors view is also going to have a lot of other data. I just haven't gotten into putting that in there. It's not going to be like sensors view in homeworld. It's going to be much better as far as I'm concerned. Alright, let's go ahead and hotkey up my interceptors. And at this point, I do not have formations at all. Formations are not an easy thing to accomplish, especially when you're dealing with the physics of all of the individual ships. I have been able to emulate what looks like formations, and it looks like, hey, you did it, but it's too processor intensive, and I need to kind of rethink how I've put that together. So I'm going to give that another whirl here. And lately I've just been kind of cleaning up different things and trying to put things together to make them function the way that I want. Alright, and we got one more second. Let's see where that squadron's coming from. There they are, over there at that planet over here. So they're on the way. Let's go ahead and pull my fighters up there. I'm going to go ahead and hotkey group. I only got one assault frigate. Alright, we'll do my fighters are group one. My assault frigate is group two. Let's move that over there. We'll move that guy right there. And keep him. Here we go. Now we're in range. So I'm going to get my group two. Start fighting that. Back to my carrier. Let's start getting out some more stuff. Let's build two more assault frigates, two more workers, 10 more interceptors. And while those guys are fighting, I need to check out my research lab. And I want to start doing capital ship. Just so I can get a destroyer out, something big and mean. And it looks like one of my support frigates is taking some damage. My ore processor is taking some damage. Let's get that worker going. So, let's see. What can I does? Alright. So we got that one support frigate. Let's get him healing up the ore processor. And it looks like that's taking some damage. And so far, so good. I've survived five waves, and I got about 50 seconds until the next one. Alright, so those workers are going. I think I got enough workers going. I'm not 100% sure. I think I got total 8 or 9. Yeah, let's build one more worker. And let's check out the lab. So we got Dare's destroyer tech. And I can also build another carrier, so then you have multiple build ships, or build capable ships. Once that is done, I think we'll go advanced fighter drive. Those bombers are pretty brutal, and I'm going to need them to take out some frigates. We got another worker. I like how the ships just kind of tumble right out of the carrier. It's the physics. I don't have the kinetics turned off, and so I'm going to kind of play with some of the formation stuff. I think the way I'm going to do it is parent object over the squads or the fighter ships, and then have some math to determine the positions inside that parent object, and then limit the physics allowed for independent movement based on whether or not the ship is in a formation and the type of formation that it's in. All right, so let's see. I got 20 interceptors now. Let's go ahead and put those in group one and get them guys fighting. And let's go over there. And then my assault frigates, I think I only have up to 3. Those guys are all group two. Let's get those guys going. And you can see they're attacking. We need to get that support frigate going over here. Let's get them up there repairing. Where's that? No, that's a research lab. Where in the hell is my... There it is, right there. Let's get those healing. Those to die. Another lazy worker. And we are going to build a destroyer and a couple of support frigates. And let's go into the lab, the research lab. Guard over here, and we are going to start with some plasma bombers, and I'm going to get Corvette drive going, so we can get some Corvettes out. So far, so good. Everything's looking all right. Running nice and smooth. All right, so there's my interceptors. Let's go ahead and move those up over here, and then number two is my assault frigates, and I will move those up here, and you can see I have a damaged one. That's going to need to be repaired. Let's get that guy going. Research, support frigate, two more support frigates. So let's put all my support frigates in group four, and then I'll just box them like that. And those guys are looking good. All the workers. I like how the workers aren't getting bunched up and humped up on each other. It just makes it, they're working perfectly, exactly as intended. For 10 workers on one collector, I think that's working a lot better than what's going on right now in the remaster. All right, we got some money coming in. Let's build some shit. There's another. There's my destroyer. Nice. Let's get that guy out of the way. And I'm going to show you how this works. So I'm going to select group one, and I'm going to tell them to guard my destroyer. Now, what will happen is the ships will not fight on themselves, and it looks like we've got some bombers coming in. Yeah. And I'm going to have those. Now, as soon as I target with my destroyer those other ships, the ships that are targeting, or the ships that are set to guard, will then start firing back and attacking once they get in range of the guard target. So you can see the ships are coming in close to the destroyer, and then they'll start their guarding sequence to fire on whatever ships are firing. You can see they fire, but they stay clustered up in guard, and I've got bombers coming in. So let's go ahead and get those assault frigates over there, shooting bombers up. See, I got my ion beams coming out of the destroyer. The destroyer's holding up. I got about half damage. Let's go ahead and get my support frigates over there to repair that guy. And I got a second destroyer out. Let's get him over there. And this can go on and on and on. I'm not going to... I think I pretty much showed you most of the stuff. The ships you haven't seen. Here's some missile corvettes. You want to see what they look like. You know, and to shoot missiles. That's right. I haven't shown you any missiles yet. So, let's see. Get them over there. So yeah, missile corvettes work like Link, just shoot missiles. Here is a missile frigate. You know, now the missile frigates, they shoot a lot slower and they need something to shoot at, so I'm going to create an enemy destroyer right up there and show you how these missile frigates work. And you can see it got these guys going. So missile frigates shoot slow missiles. Kind of not like a missile corvette. And the way that you adjust that is very simple. You just jump, let's say you go into a missile corvette, you go into the weapon stat, and you're adjusting the speed of the missile. It's right here, plain and simple. All right, guys, I just wanted to give you a little update so you can see how far I've gotten already. This is absolutely playable, and I'm really looking for some people to help me test this out. And, you know, I need to test it on different machines. I need to start testing it on with different graphics cards. And also, I want to play test some of the functionality and make sure I'm getting this close to what it should be. All right, guys, if you're interested in helping out, just post some comments below or shoot me an email. You can find me on homeworld.guru, and I'm pretty much lurking in the TeamSpeak channel all the time. So any of that, come and hit me up. All right, ooh, I need to, that destroyer's good. I need to get that one repaired. That one's taking some damage. And let's see. Now, I am going to do move attack orders for the capital ships. So that is coming, but at the moment is not in the game. And bam, I just lost the destroyer. So, anyway, you can see how that works. And these guys are, those are plasma bombers. So you can see the bombers just shoot plasma bombs, if you're wondering what the heck that is. And over here, I've got a bunch of missile corvettes. Might as well get them in the mix. Got a couple of missile frigates over here. There's another destroyer. But anyway, I'm going to stop the video and see how far I can get, you know, off screen. But I just wanted to keep you guys up to date. If you got any questions or you want to help, like I said, just put some comments below. And I'll catch you in the next video. Thanks a lot, guys. Mm-hmm.